Hey guys, doing a little food video today. So basically, one thing we're really short on right now is time. So we're going to use an Instapot to make this. Today, we're doing a little bit of pulled pork. So I got myself a slab of pork, and to save time, I already threw some seasoning and spices on it. What's on it, you might ask? Doesn't matter. Put some stuff on you like. That's not even the point of all this. I'm going to throw this in the Instapot, and I'm going to get back to you in just a minute here on how this is going. Thank you very much for watching. It's very important you wash your hands during all of this. The only way to survive an apocalypse is to not touch your face and to wash your hands and to stay inside. It's the hardest thing humanity's ever had to do to save ourselves in a very long time. So apparently we have to wash for at least 20 seconds. I don't know why I went up to my elbow, but I think on occasion it's probably a good idea. Okay, so the next step is we're going to throw this big slab of meat in the old Instapot here. I've got my survival knife. Ba-boop, ba-boom, ba-boop, ba-boom. This is no time to be conservative. This is a big piece of meat. We want to cut it into about three pieces so we can stack this beast on top of itself. This knife is not as good as I would have thought it would be, but it's still going to do its job. Now, we take these giant slabs of meat that we've all chopped up here, and we throw them into the Instapot. Boom! One! And they're all nice and seasoned, loving it. What the hell is going on here? Two. Three. Stick that meat in the Instapot. It's beautiful. Now, what we're going to do is, we're going to take a liberal dosing of 99-cent root beer. You know, during an apocalypse, you don't want to go all out for no fucking reason. We're going to pour that in there. I don't know. Yeah, let's add a bit more because this looks delicious. Yeah, you know, you can get crazy, but root beer does the job. So does Coca-Cola. So does Dr. Pepper. All very wonderful options. You know what? Is that a liberal dosing? I don't know. A little more. This is how we cook. Put a lid on this thing. We're going to get it cooking. I'll be right back to let you know how it turns out. So, turns out there's a little more to slow cooking with an Instapot when I don't want to slow cook with it, and that doesn't make no difference. Long story short, I'm not teaching you how to use that thing. I had to read a bunch of stuff. Disclaimer. After 45 minutes reading about how to use the Instapot, I pushed the meat button and I moved it up to 45 minutes. It looks like it's on. I don't know if it is. I don't know if I did this right. We will find out soon enough. Peace.
Do our hair.
So I waited about 10 minutes. It doesn't look like this Instapot is doing anything yet. Can we even see that? No. But it says on. So I decide I'm going to go over to the stove. I'm going to set the timer to 45 minutes. Let's see if anything happens. I don't know if this thing's even working. It's a hard day. Just a quick update. I have 17 minutes left on my stove. And 23 minutes left on my Instapot. I think I'm onto something, but the Instapot seems to be a little slower than instant. Okay, because I spent so much time getting this Instapot ready, I forgot about the other half of this project. 4 cups of flour. This is a half a cup. Sometimes I wonder what my life is coming to when I cannot find my 1 cup measuring spoon. I got my 1 cup of flour. My 2 cup of flour, which wasn't quite 2, so my 3 cup, I just make sure it's more than 3 like that. And then I'm like, because I know cooking is a precise science. 4 cup of flour, boom! This one is going to go on some baking powder. Powder. And I need 1 tiny spoon, not the big spoon, the teaspoon. A round container. I don't understand this, I hate cooking! And then it's like, hey, why don't you put like a teaspoon of salt in there? I'm like, that sounds like a lot of salt. I don't know how much salt we use in this world. That has to happen. Viral preparedness. Whisk this up with a spoonage. So now, we need some lard. I don't got a lard. It's an apocalypse. I'm using margarine. It works. A little more than 2 tablespoons is not going to hurt anything if you want a softer end product, and I ain't gonna tell you what it is just yet. Now's the funky part. I did wash my hands off camera. We gotta get down and dirty, and we gotta mix this in. Okay? Don't toy around. I'm gonna bring that over here and watch me mix in the lard.
Mmm.
It's supposed to get crumbly and turn into little crumbly bits, which is making me think I've done something drastically. We'll find out soon enough.
So it turns out the next step actually involves some serious work. Hence,
cup and a half of water.
I washed my hands, by the way.
It said lightly floured. I don't make the rules. I just follow them. It's like staying inside after I shut it off.
This is a lot of flour here, Nathan. So I separated it just so that it was a smaller amount of dough.
Because you need to knead it for a few minutes until it's smooth and elastic.
I don't even know why I got stuck with this job.
Is this the hard part?
Just kidding, I was pretending I was Superwoman. Beat that dough.
Yeah. Perfect. Woo! All right, so the next step is equally difficult. Lee, I need you to break this into 24 even pieces.
Oh, I almost rubbed my face, but I didn't
do it. You did rub your face.
No, I went up for it, man. I was like so close. God, these are dough balls, man.
I'm sorry, my friends. I know this part of the show is incredibly boring. Watching Lee make her dough balls. Balls. Stargate 03-29-2020. The dough balls are finally ready. That was a lot of work. I'm gonna go have a smoke break. This is a complete disaster. I don't know what's going on with the slow pot. This thing is like 5 hours into cooking this stuff. Now the timer says 44 more minutes. Phase two begins. This is the start of phase two. Crazy world we live in. I don't know how we're going to survive. We're all stuck staying at home, waiting for people to invent better ways to do our jobs so we don't have to anymore. Automate the system. We'll make it.
Yeah, because this didn't even call for yeast, right?
Big as you can get them, really.
I think that's about it, Knox. It's as far as these little babies want to stretch.
Nobody tells me anything. I don't know if this is even going to work or not. I threw like 2 drops of oil. Bam! Like 2 minutes on the timer. I'm still trying to figure out why this thing now says 53 minutes and it used to be 47 minutes. I'm trying to understand. I think maybe it's done and it's been done for 54 minutes. We're gonna wait and find out.
And now it's time to flip the first one. It's been 2 minutes. Ding. Flip, flip. Oh, a little bit of golden. Do that again?
No.
Man's work is never done. We are making our own tortillas, yo!
Make another little taco in my heart now, baby.
Come on, and roll it. Roll another few little taco rounds now, baby. Whoa, roll it. Roll another few while so we can eat some dinner.
That's a weird shaped taco. I guess they all come in different sizes, eh?
That's what she said.
Come on, I'm a genius. Wash your hands.
By the way, someone's stuck doing a lot of real work. Hard work, man. Staying at home is not easy.
Lee, these are supposed to be circles, not Rojak paintings.
Hey, this is what I gotta say. I got a good job in the city, working for the man every night and day. Rolling, woo, rolling on the dough ball. Got it all, rolling in the deep. Roll your boat gently down the stream. Merrily, 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 merrily. Physical distancing.
You used to laugh about everybody that was hanging out.
starvation is starting to set in. Come on over here, I gotta show you this. And boom, this is our meat. You wanna hold this? How are you gonna hold this while you hold that? Pause. Now that we got the meat all pulled apart, that looks pretty good. No joke, you can go right from here. This is my next step, and I don't care what barbecue sauce it is. This is the first time I ever used this one. They're all great. Love the bourbon, love the butter, love the apple. Anything you would do with pork, let's get crazy with the cheese whiz. Like, we are not holding back. We are going bottles out. We mix it all up. Yeah, you guys thought it was a lot, right? Now all of a sudden you're starting to understand the whole process. You thought I was crazy. Well, I might be crazy, but in this one, I was right. Check this out, woman. My God, it's delicious. Do I know? I'm about to find out. Would I do it again? Yeah, I'd try that slow pot again. And soon we will be eating. Well, I'll get right to that in a minute. Well, I guess I'm ready to have a taco. Had to glue it, kill it, grill it. Well, good thing we prepared this all together, because we're breaking all the rules of safety and sanitization. We did our best, and brought it home. Well, honestly, I didn't have a lot of hope for this, when it was all going down. Happy to put in the effort. Have a bite. Just kidding. Social distancing. See you next time.
I'm sorry. Captain's log. Today was a long day. We worked hard, we trained hard, we suffered. We all had to give a little to get a lot. The crew says that they didn't understand what they were doing until the very end. Maybe they say that the captain's keeping them in the dark on things, but honestly, I just want to make sure that everybody gets home safe. Survival Guide, Episode 1. How to keep your woman happy in the middle of a crisis.
Make tacos.